Hello, this is John from MyBirdOnGames.com. I'm here today to continue playing Ease, the Vanished Omens for the Sega Master System. It is August 11th, 2006, Thursday evening. This is the sixth episode, I believe, of my Let's Play for this game. I believe that is correct, and that is correct. Episode 6. See, in the last episode, I reached level... Ooh, man. I just about made a big boo-boo overriding my primary save. Speaking of which, I better make a duplicate of this. Anyways, in the last video, we reached level 7. Yes, I reached level 7. I think I've fully explored the first three floors of this palace. Got the silver bells, returned those to the mayor of Zepik. Got a few new items, got a few new rings. In general, leveling up and acquiring those rings has helped me a ton. And I think I kind of came to the conclusion that I need to be level 8 to pass through the fourth floor and beyond. Now, I know I can deal with the enemies on level 4 or on the fourth floor, but really going to need to level up to deal with them properly. So, more grinding is in store. Seems like each of these videos is going to start with a fair amount of grinding, but the trend has been I do a little bit of grinding and make some significant progress. So, that is what's on the docket tonight. I think I'm going to retreat back a couple floors and let my health regenerate before trying to grind. I think I'll try and grind on the fourth floor. I think I can deal with those enemies pretty well. I say as I just about fall victim to some enemies on the third floor. Better save. I need saving that top slot. I always like having the top slot. There's another kind of catch-up day at work today. The boss who we office with is a small office, just me serving account, doing accounting functions, HR functions. Working in a small business as we are. Everyone has their hand in everything. I do a lot of IT, do a lot of HR, do a lot of accounting. Have to be able to multitask, have to be able to do a lot. But our office is just myself, co-worker, handles HR primarily, and the owner. And our office is just right down from the primary grocery store, the headquarters, as it were. He's been out of the office this week. He'll return tomorrow. But while he's been out of office, it's been kind of quiet. As well as him being gone. General manager and a couple of these store managers were out. Again, kind of lending a sense of quiet to the workplace. So it's allowed us in the office to get caught up. Took that opportunity today, so it's a little bit of a slower day. One of the highlights was Crystal Pepsi. I saw on Facebook earlier this week that looks like some Walmarts in the Oklahoma area, specifically around Oklahoma City metropolitan area, had gotten Crystal Pepsi. They were touting some displays, some of the workers at these locations. And I inquired, must have been Tuesday. No, it must have been, maybe it was yesterday. I checked with the manager on duty to see, hey, do we have Crystal Pepsi? Are we getting it? What's the status of this? And coincidentally, a Pepsi guy was there, so he went and checked. I don't think we originally were set to receive any, but he made sure to order some, and he ordered a pretty significant quantity. Because I think, like me, he is interested in the concept of it, kind of the limited nature of it, and him personally, he actually liked it from back in the day. I never had it, so for me, it's kind of been a big dumb novelty, but a big dumb novelty I can get behind. I wanted to try it. And today, So when we got that, so around lunchtime, I headed over to the store to see if we had it in stock, and sure enough, we did. They had just got there not too long before I went over there. So they hadn't built a display or put it out on the sales floor or anything, but they did have it in the back room. It was set up in this computer system, so I went ahead and bought some. And it's not bad. I remember, you know, watching I Love the 90s and reading about pop culture stuff of the late 80s, early 90s. Seems like it was heavily, heavily panned. Not popular. But to me, it tasted like Pepsi. Tasted almost like maybe slightly watered down, and whenever I say that, that kind of lends a negative connotation to it. So I didn't think it was a negative experience. I didn't think it being, you know, a little watered down, as that phrase indicates. I think a more appealing phrase would be it's a little bit airier, a little bit lighter than a normal Pepsi. Am I on the third floor? I'm on the third floor. I need to go to the left, not to the right. Since I had to go down just to the first floor to restore my health, kind of lost position of myself in the palace. But anyway, so I had that during lunch. I brought one home for Jenny and we drank it again. Kind of enjoy it. I will probably get some more whenever I was speaking to the Pepsi rep. He made it seem like its long-term availability was doubtful. The local bottler, it seemed like they got an insignificant amount compared to the amount of stores who would be purchasing it. And he said that it was kind of going quickly. Retailers weren't buying a lot of it, he made it seem, but they were buying, you know, everyone's buying a little bit. And at that rate, it's going to wind up going away if Pepsi doesn't keep it in rotation. And I don't think they will. With it being so heavily panned the first go-around, back in the early 90s or late 80s, whenever it was specifically. And, you know, for them right now, this is a good marketing thing. It's like what I was talking about in yesterday's video. Talking about, like, the McRib here in the States. Having it be a limited time item allows it to be an event of sorts. And hey, I mean, they've suckered me into it. I'm sitting here espousing it across two videos, across 2 days. I've got it. I want more. But, long story short, it's okay. After that, came home and Jenny had the day off. So I think she spent a lot of it just playing No Man's Sky and resting up. She wasn't feeling too good. I don't want to save. I really want to check my status. 8,300 out of 12,800. And we just kind of snacked. We foraged pretty much for dinner. Didn't watch any of the Olympics tonight. I did, however, spend way too long, maybe an hour and a half, 2 hours, watching a documentary on Nixon. PBS, I guess, is just playing documentaries about presidents, going chronologically right now. Because last night I was watching one about LBJ. Or at least LBJ and the Civil Rights Act of 1964. I think PBS is just playing series of presidential documentaries. But again, just as I was saying with LBJ, I think it applies to Nixon as well. He was a very smart political creature, very cunning. And he made a lot of accomplishments during his presidency. In the lead up to his first presidential term, you know, through the 50s and 60s as a House member, a senator, attempted governor of California, he seemed very partisan, very much an attack dog. He was also vice president for Eisenhower. Seemed very partisan, very, very strong-willed. Seemed like he started to attempt to appeal to a broader base, and eventually that helped him get elected. Seemed like for the early portions of his career, he was a very partisan figure and either loved or loathed. And during his early years in the presidency, first term, it seemed like he accomplished really great things considering the time. I mean, with the help of Kissinger and his whole staff, Henry Kissinger, Secretary of State, I believe, and, you know, the staff and all the people involved, went to China, the first president. I think it was the first president to do so, and especially the first since communist rule. Lots of negotiations there, lots of negotiations with Soviet Russia. First president to enter the Kremlin, signed a weapons deal to start scaling back the weapons production, nuclear production, all that stuff. So, I mean, very forward-thinking president, very courageous in that regard. At the same time, had the turmoil of Vietnam War to deal with. And while it wasn't his war, it was an inherited war. Seemed like over time definitely became his war. That's kind of one of the core points of this documentary, one of the things they discussed a lot. And, you know, it did bother his presidency a lot, it seemed like. He would always go against the grain, or oftentimes go against the grain or against the wishes of his advisors. They would suggest one thing and he would think, no, I need, you know, in my mind, think, no, I need to do something else. That's not going to help. Because he was wanting to win the war. He didn't want to be the first American president to lose a war, just as LBJ thought. And because of that, he was only interested in actions that would result into a war won. And he did negotiate a ceasefire. But it seemed like it was pretty short-lived. You know, Vietnam is a big black eye for America, a big black eye for probably a lot of the parts of the world. You know, I'm not a history major or anything like that. I can't speak to how the Vietnam War was interpreted or how other countries were involved and how they dealt with that, but I know for America that was definitely a black eye for the country. And that's something still talked about today. I think the shadow of that war still lingers. I know during the Iraq and Afghanistan war, many people were quick to draw comparisons. But what ultimately did him in was the Watergate scandal. He was so interested in winning, he had suffered a couple of political defeats in his career that really demoralized him, and he was the type of person who didn't want to lose. So whenever it came to his 1972 re-election, he wanted to win with the largest majority ever. And I don't know that he did, but I think he won every state but Massachusetts, which, thinking about that, that sounds impossible. So the fact that he was able to do that is mind-blowing. At the same time, he was a Republican, and Republicans did not win the House or the Senate. So, I don't know how successful he would be in making work happen domestically, getting bills passed, spearheading issues that he wanted, or tackling issues in a way that he wanted, not how the opposition wanted. At the same time, that would force him to work with the opposite side, which I think is something really lacking in modern American politics. But it definitely gets, you know, watching stuff like that definitely gives me, if it doesn't already strengthen my respect for those individuals, those presidents, it gives me newfound respect. Especially in this case for Nixon, just to see how smart he was. I mean, regardless of your views on his political policies and the way he treated his opponents, which he was vicious, he was ruthless with his opponents. He was a politically smart man. And he was well suited to be a politician, especially during that era. And that's that. That's going to be politics for this hour. I have not played much Pokemon Go today. We did not go for a walk. It's bloody hot here. I think the high today was 100, 100 and something. Okay, again, I'm on the third floor. I need to go left. I keep wanting to go up to the northeast, but I need to go to the northwest. The high today was 100, but with the heat index, it actually feels like it's 105 or 110. So days like this, as soon as I get off work, I got like a 10-15 minute drive to the house. Even doing that with the air conditioning, it's something where I just want to get inside, take my clothes off, and get in the air conditioning. Stay cool. Thankfully, we're scheduled to get some rain tonight. And the high for the next week or so, actually, I think until next Sunday, maybe. It's only scheduled to be in the mid-80s, which is fantastic for right now, especially after going through a couple hundred-degree days. I can't wait for that. Wow, and this guy's tearing me up. I'm gonna load. I'm not gonna continue on with that. What's the experience we got? 10,000 out of 12,000 needed, 13,000 needed. So it looks like this upcoming week is going to be very conducive to Pokemon Go. So I'm very interested in getting out and playing that, and hopefully maybe even doing some biking, maybe going for a jog or two, playing some tennis. Need to enjoy the mild weather while it lasts. Because before I know it, it's going to be winter. It's going to be too cold to do much outside. $10,280, that must not have been my experience. I must be thinking of the 12,800 just because it shared many digits. Actually, yeah, that was all the same digits, just in a different order. Yeah, these guys are still giving me some issue. What ring do I have? Power ring equipped. We have the power ring. Let's try the ring mail. Let's buff our defense. So this is going to reduce the damage dealt to Aaron by half. And of course, the power ring was increasing the damage I dealt, so it's going to take longer to deal with these enemies. But if that first enemy is any indication, this will be a better scenario. Back to 10,280. Go ahead and save there. Looks like we have just about 50% of health remaining. And tomorrow, I'm looking forward to tomorrow. I always look forward to Fridays. Working weekdays, Monday through Friday. In many ways, I am working for the weekend. But tomorrow will be a fun Friday. Plan on going to see a Frank Zappa documentary with my dad, mom, and sister, Jenny. He is a big fan of Frank Zappa. And this is showing at a local nonprofit independent theater in Tulsa, Circle Cinema. So I always like going there. They play a lot of cool stuff. I think the last maybe 2 years I've really gotten into them and really just pay attention to everything they release there. Kind of coincides with me watching more movies, trying to broaden my pop culture lens and also my reference point for movies, film, actors, all that sort of stuff, directors, composers. But, so we're going to go see that tomorrow. I'm interested. I'm never listened to a lot of Frank Zappa music, so for me it'll be an educational experience. And then tomorrow, also, the Stranger Things soundtrack comes out, the first volume of it at least. Stranger Things being the zeitgeist on Netflix at the moment. Jenny and I watched that after I heard so much hubbub about it on Twitter. Talking with some other people, everybody mentioned it, so at some point, it's like, okay, let's sit down and watch this. Let's see what all the fuss is about. I already knew I was going to like it. Going into it, I knew that. How much I was going to like it, I didn't think I'd like it this much. We watched the first five, it's an 8-episode series on Netflix. We watched the first 5 episodes in one night. And we were seriously contemplating just finishing out the whole series. I think we were sitting there doing the math, thinking, okay, well, we've got this many episodes left, they're this long. If we watch all of it, that would put us at 2 o'clock, 2 in the morning. That's about whenever I go to sleep anyways. We could do this, we could do this. Eventually, we relented and said, well, we'll wait. And I think the following night, we finished the series. And then just last week, I introduced it to my parents, my sister, and they did the exact same thing. They watched the first 5 episodes in one night. Jenny and I were over there celebrating my father's birthday. And I think we stayed for the first 2 or 3 episodes. And then once we left, they continued on watching the 3 more. And then, like I said, did the same thing the following night. They finished the series up. But one of the things that's exceptional about that show is the soundtrack. Both the curated and original compositions. I mean, especially the original compositions. It is set in the 80s, so the curated soundtrack mostly deals with music from the 80s. There are some other songs in there from 70s, I think The Clash, Should I Stay or Should I Go, that was late 70s, early 80s. And then Jefferson Airplane, Jefferson Starship, White Rabbit, that was from late 60s. But it's a fantastic song, and it fit the scene they were going for pretty good. And like I said, it's a fantastic song. I personally love that song. But the original compositions, composed by a pair out of Austin, Texas, I think in a group called Survive, maybe? I think that is what this soundtrack is going to be composed of, their original compositions. And there was a lot of 80s-sounding synth rock, synth pop. And it sounds really good. You know, it definitely evokes that era, but it evokes that era without being too corny or too cheesy. And that fit right into my personal listening right now. I've been listening to, we've been listening to an 80s pop station at work. The current Muzak station we're on is 80s pop, 80s rock. And the last month or so, and I've just been taking notes at work whenever I hear a song I like or a band I like, it's like, oh, I need to remember to get that, or I need to download that. And I've gotten a couple new CDs in the process. So I've kind of been living in the 80s musically for the last month or so. I think right now I'm jamming on Tears for Fears and their album Songs from the Big Chair, which of course had Shout and Everyone Wants to Rule the World. Those are two real well-known singles. They also had 2 lesser-known singles, or at least lesser-known to me. Mother's Talk, which is really rocking, really hardcore, almost a precursor to industrial music, or a precursor to, you know, hardcore industrial music. And Head Over Heels Broken, which is another beautiful song. I think that LP, that album, has become one of my favorite albums. It's just 8 or 9 songs long, and I think all of them I like. There's one song that I don't listen to whenever I listen to it in the car, which is pretty much every time I drive. But I also got the deluxe edition, because it was cheap on Amazon. It has many different versions of the singles. Mother's Talk, specifically, which I think is my favorite song, if not my second favorite song, which unfortunately they didn't care for. You know, there's some interviews on there with them, and the booklet it comes with, they talk about each of the songs, and Mother's Talk is the one that gets a lot of, you know, either shrugs or apparent disdain from them. They did not care for it the way it sounds, but I, on the other hand, love it. And as well as those, there's a collection of B-sides that were released on those singles at the time, and those are, you know, definitely B-side worthy. I couldn't see those being singles, some of them, but I really liked their low-key nature and just the experimentation they were going with, and kind of the monotonous repeating notes. I really enjoyed that. Thing tore me up. Wow. But yeah, so even the B-sides on there, I love. I think all in all, that's jumped to be one of my favorite albums. But I am interested to get Stranger Things soundtrack when that comes out. It comes out digitally tomorrow. August the 12th. Yeah, it comes out digitally August 12th, 2016, but a CD release, a physical release, impending. I think that comes in September. So if I do get it, I'll hold out for that. My sister may go ahead and get the digital version. I'm one who loves... I wouldn't say I love physical media. I haven't had to move around a lot, so I think once that happens, I'll start to not care about physical media so much, but that's one thing I always try and do. If I'm buying something, whether it's a movie, a video game, or music, I try and get the physical version. Be it a CD, DVD, Blu-ray, or, you know, the physical game itself. They have a permanence that I appreciate, the ability to look at something, read a booklet while I'm listening to music, or, you know, reference point for playing a game. Again, like this game, I don't have the manual for it. I just have the case and the game. If I had the manual, that'd be so helpful. You know, granted, I can just pull up the manual online, so it's kind of a moot point. But I really like just being able to hold something in front of me and interact with it. The same thing with books. I'd rather have a physical book than buy something on Nook or buy something on a Kindle. Just about there. And one of the benefits of that nowadays, it seems like, CDs especially, you can get them pretty cheap. New CDs, pretty cheap. Used CDs, incredibly cheap. I mean, that Songs from the Big Chair album, it was the deluxe edition, two set. I mean, it has like 25, 30 songs on it. Now, granted, many of them, probably half of them, are just single edits or single remixes. Still, they are unique recordings. They are different. Okay, yeah, we need to go back and heal. But that was only, you know, $13 on Amazon, which is, you know, what I expect to pay for a brand new CD. And that one has a nice booklet, lots of notes, all sorts of stuff. But yeah, I fear once I don't intend on moving around a lot, but I bet after another move, I'll start to look down a little bit on physical media. Probably not. I'm pretty set in my ways. I like owning physical media. I mean, look behind me. Got a couple bookshelves worth of games right there, and that's not even all of it. So yeah, in my mind, long live physical media. And plus with physical media, like with music, the way I use my music, you know, I have the CD. The first thing I do is burn it to my computer and then put it on my phone or put on something to listen to. And then just keep the CD in the car or keep the CD someplace where I may listen to a CD at. So I use both. And Spotify, Pandora, it's not like I am a Luddite with those. I still use Spotify, Pandora. They're helpful in finding new artists, new songs. Songs I didn't know an artist performed, something like that. They're very good as a discovery tool. But for me, who doesn't have an unlimited data plan for my cell phone, it's impractical to use all the time. You know, maybe if I had an unlimited data plan, I'd probably move away from getting so much physical media because I'd have access to a giant library via those sources and be able to listen to them whenever I run or go for a bike ride. I said that weird, a bike ride. But again, I say, man, I keep I'm basically arguing with myself here. I'm debating myself. And continuing on with that, in the butt part, pretty much all my music collection is stored on my computer, which I operate Plex off of, so I basically got a little media server for all that. So whenever I'm in the house, connected to Wi-Fi, I just stream everything to the TV or stream it to my phone, listen to stuff while I cook or while I'm cleaning the house. And, you know, whenever I am away, if I'm connected to Wi-Fi, I can still access that. I can access it, you know, whenever I'm out roaming around, use the cell towers, but again, that drives up the data usage. Especially with music, that'll drive it up pretty fast. It's been like a solid half hour of grinding. But we're just about to 8. So what are we at? 11,950. Yeah, we're just about there. What was my gold? Oh man, I should have been going back to town. I forgot to keep an eye on my gold as well. See, 11,950. I guess let's get up to 8 real quick, and then we'll go buy a new set of armor or a new shield. Or maybe we won't get up to 8. We'll try and get up to 8 unless my health falls too low. Then we'll head back to Manea. But we'll try and get to 8 before doing that. Just about there. Man, that guy was giving it to me. Thankfully, we had just saved. I tend to use we a lot. I'm using the royal we a lot. I guess that comes as a result of recording this. I feel like I'm playing this with you, the watcher, the viewer. And I do try and break away or try and say, you know, I am doing this or I need this much to level up, but I guess it's just a habit now that I'm saying we. So I may as well continue doing that. It's probably a little more inclusive method of discussing what I'm doing at the moment. Looks like I need to go down and come back up to let enemies respawn. Because I'm not getting anything. There's one now. Oh yeah, keep your back to me. Or is that your neck? They just look like little floating heads, little wandering heads. See, what are we at? 12,790. Okay, we are right there. What's my gold at? 10,000. Okay, yeah, we can get upgraded armor and shields. We'll just start heading back to Manea, because I'll get that level up with the next enemy I kill. Hopefully this guy doesn't kill me! Got him. Man, are we just about maxed out? I wonder if the health bar keeps growing after I reach the edge, whenever it starts overlapping. 12,860 out of 25,600. 10,000 gold. Health still doesn't regenerate on this floor. We'll go ahead and save on that second file as well. Got my eyes set on you, yellow. Coming after you. Don't run away now. Green Paris, take him out on my way. Oh yeah, those things shouldn't give me too much trouble now that I've leveled up once more. Health still doesn't regenerate on this floor. So I still have to go down to that first floor if I want to regenerate my health while I'm in the palace. I've spent a lot of time in this palace too. I mean, if you think about it, this is the 6th episode. I've spent, what, 3 or 4 episodes in the palace? It'd be nice if my health regenerated quicker as I leveled up as well, or regenerate in larger chunks. this point, I may want to buy a wing. I think wings transport me back to a town. If I had a wing, it would make getting to Manea much quicker than actually going back through the palace, going through Zepik, the fields, to reach Manea. Not sure if I can use a wing inside the palace or if I'd have to get outside. Either way, it'd still shave some time off. I don't need to wait for my health to regenerate either. None of these enemies are going to give me issues. With this, we will have bought all the strongest items from Manea. I wonder where I'll find better equipment. I wonder if there's another town in the game. I kinda think these are the only two towns in the game. With as much time as I've been spending in the palace trying to get through it, I don't know how big the Kingdom of Ease is, or at least the kingdom as they present it in this game. Come on, that guy can't defend my hits anymore. Okay, here come those drowsy eyelids. Looks like it's gonna start now. Which I actually stayed up a little bit last night after doing this. Played some more Final Fantasy VI. And like I said, I wasn't gonna tackle that Kefka cultist tower, since I realized that is not a mandatory thing. And sure enough, I went to Jador, went to Owser's mansion, found Realm. Looked like he had hired her to do some painting. Of course, there were demons involved. Demons somehow. I don't need to be at this guy's place. How much is a wing? 200? May as well. I don't have a mirror either. 1,000 for a mirror. Not buying it right now. Human. Oh, come on. But yeah, found Realm. We went through that little recruitment spiel. Fought some demons. Saved her, saved Owser. And I'm guessing she is back in Themasa. Because she didn't join my party right away. It seemed like she retreated back once all was done. So I need to head back to that town. What? Was that wing 2,000 gold or 200 gold? Oh man, was that 2,000? What the crap? I thought it said 200. I must not have been paying attention. I gotta blame that one on those drowsy eyelids. Okay, so it looks like I will load that save up. I'm just going to go back and talk to him again. I could swore that said 200. No, I don't want to leave. I want to buy. Okay. Whatever. We'll load. God, that stinks. I'm still level 8, though. Okay, well, back to Manea we go. So I wonder if that wing is a permanent item or just a usable item that's only one use. I would think it'd be a consumable item where I can only use it once and have to go buy another one, but whenever I have that, he said, nope, that's the only one I had. You bought it. Also spent 2,000 on it, not 200. That high cost makes me think maybe it is a reusable item. But yeah, back to Final Fantasy VI, so I ended there. I only played for like half an hour last night before falling asleep. Listened to the new Giant Bombcast as well. So I will try and play some more of that tonight. Recruit her, get her in the party, and then she is the requirement to get Strago. He is with the Kefka cultist, but he looks like he's been brainwashed. He's with them, so she'll probably be able to snap him out of it and have him join my party. I'm not going to use either of them, probably. You know, they were the last additions to the party, so they're the ones I'm least familiar with. And they're also specialized in a style of gameplay that I don't care too much for. So I don't think I'll use them much, but I still want to get them. I'm not going for 100% run or anything. I've already missed my opportunity on that and saying that I'll probably won't tackle that cultist tower. But I still want to recruit as many team members as possible, just in case anything does happen. That'll hopefully make it a little easier. More power in numbers. Let's go ahead and save out here. And with those two in my party, I think I'm done, with the exception of Locke. But in the quick scan through of a walkthrough I did, quick look ahead, it looks like he is the last one to get. He is the centerpiece at this point. No, well, not the centerpiece, but he is the core focus whenever going through trying to recruit everyone back. So it looks like, and I also know I'm, you know, I did that just to see kind of how far away from the end of that game I was, because I don't think I'm going to do too much. I don't know that I'll do any of the side quest stuff, actually. I've done some of it as I've been flying around the world of Ruin looking for everybody to recruit, because that part I did totally walk through free, just flying around, talking to everyone in town, seeing if people said anything new, if they had new items. Maybe find some of the missing espers I have, or missing espers I don't have. So as a result of that, I have completed a fair amount of the side questy stuff. So I think once I get Locke, I'm pretty much gonna barrel through, do what grinding I have to, and put a bow on it, be able to move on to Final Fantasy VII. Before that, though, I think I will resume the Uncharted series. Play Uncharted 3. I think that one's Drake's Deception. I don't have it here, I think it's over on the shelf. See, Reflex. Armor made from the special material Reflex is light but strong. I will buy that for 5,000. And then a shield, the large shield. It offers much protection, but is a bit heavy, whilst thou buy it for 6,000. Okay, so that's 6,000. I am still a little off. But we've got the reflex armor. Does it look like we have room for two more items or one more item? I need equipment screen, not status screen. Now it looks like I could have two more items. And what we'll do to verify that, let's load up one of these pre-existing saves. Yeah, so there are five items. Maybe not for shield and armor, or at least the person who had this save did not get any further shield or armor. Not going to do too much more looking, don't want to spoil much. Don't want to spoil every... Whoa. That sucks. But I have this save, which is still level 8. Wow, my heart just dropped for a second. Oh man, I'm so glad I did that second save. Now I'm thinking I need to do a third save, just to prevent myself from getting shot in the foot. Okay, but upside to that is now we know we need 11,000 gold, so I'm going to stick around a little longer and grind for some gold. These guys give me like 50, right? Yeah, 50, I think 50 and 60 from those yellow guys and the green Paris. 50 and 60. I think I'll play my luck with the enemies on the fourth floor. I'm not mistaken, those give me like 80. Well, they're not giving me that much more. And these enemies are almost assuredly not going to give me trouble. But I am level 8 now. I don't think I've combated one of these guys at being level 8, or maybe that was the one where I combated and I turned level 8. These guys aren't giving me any difficulties now. I say that, and this one probably will. Nope. Just about there. In fact, I can start heading that way. Man, time flies. Now I said a little bit ago it'd been half an hour, it's already been 45 minutes, seemed like those last 15 minutes really flew by. The grinding not so much, but those last 15 minutes for sure. I'm gonna take these guys out. They were asking for it. Yeah, you're not going to give me trouble. No more will you give me trouble as I try and get down to the second floor. I'm getting those drowsy, those heavy eyelids. I'm nearing the end of this video, though. I'd like to see what's beyond the fourth floor before calling it quits for the night. So we will get at least that far. What's my gold at? 11,384, so I'm going to drop that down to 384. Just trying to figure if I wanted to grind an additional 2,000 and just go ahead and get that wing. Just to test it out and see if it is a consumable. Well, I could always save right before buying it and then test it out, see if it's a consumable or reusable item. And then just load another save after I've tried it. But the way things are going, I may accidentally save over what I'm trying to load. This shuffle. And I just bump the table. I'm sitting here drumming along to the music, bump the table with my thigh. Probably picked it up on the microphone. Sorry about that. You get better about not doing that. Soundtrack needs to get better at not being so darn hummable, so darn drummable. Yeah, I need to check to see if I can find this somewhere. Soundtrack. See how much an import costs, or if there are downloads out there somewhere. crazy enough to do it. Okay, we're gonna save there. I'm also gonna save there. Okay, so we want to buy the wing. 2,000 sounds good, my friend. 2,000 sounds good. I could swore I was hitting right on the controller, but I went straight down. Wing. Ooh, it regenerates my health. Okay. It is a one-time item, though. I wonder if he sells another one now. Looks like he may not let you stock up on them. He will sell you one at a time. Yep. You can have one in your inventory at a time. So, we are not going to concern ourselves with that for the time being. Instead, we're going to concern ourselves with better equipment, better armor, better shield. In fact, the best we can attain at this point. Maybe ever, judging by that save, maybe this is just the flat out bit. Well, they're silver armor. Now, I know he doesn't have it. It was stolen from him, but I imagine at some point in the game you do acquire silver armor, silver shield. The plate mail and reflex, and we don't want that potion. We'll go ahead and equip the power ring again. Okay, we're gonna be rocking and a rolling. I'm trying not to talk to people. What do you say about Silver Sword? Lies waiting for someone somewhere in the land. Let's go and save. Don't need to worry about these enemies. I don't need to be spending that extra second or two going after them for what little experience and gold they'll yield. I do kind of want to go into this cave now. Gained one more level, have equipped better armor, better shield. We'll let the health regenerate. I'll let this guy come closer. Come on. Come on. Don't run away. I don't know. Okay, they're both coming at me now. Dog and human. Dog and creature. Getting close. Not coming after me, though. Oh, man. Had a pretty good itch. Oh, wow. I can take these guys down. Let's see, 14-0 and 660. 14-0. 14-0. 14-2. So 200 experience, 200 gold. I know where I'm coming next. These guys aren't even giving me trouble now. I wonder what's in here. Maybe I should just explore this cave. Oh, I got a ghost. The amount of gold these guys give me, it'd be worth it to go buy a wing just to keep in reserve. A timer ring. Okay. What is a timer ring? Well, it's not going to say there. Let me pull up the manual real quick. Timer ring. Wear this and the enemy will move at half the speed. Okay. Well, may come in handy during boss fights, but I don't know how much it'll come in handy against just these routine enemies. Probably ought to save. Yeah, I didn't save. Okay, this is not a cave, this is a mine. Guess it's kind of the same thing. Oh, another new enemy type. Nice if I had a bigger window of vision. That's all well and good. But let's head back to the palace. I want to finish working there before I start this new journey. Start this new exploration of the mines. There we go. This is the exit. Let's check out that timer ring in action. Weird. Keep it equipped for the time being until we get to the palace. So many people to avoid talking to. I just want to get to Jebba's house, see if she heals me. Ah. Okay, still nothing new there. They don't heal me. I guess I'll get this back to my power ring. Let's make way for the palace once more. Okay, so I wonder if I'm just about done with the palace, now that I can not only enter those mines, but stand a chance at exploring them. What was my experience at again? 15,000 out of 25,000. Long way to go. I think that's about roughly 10,000 experience. Those guys give me 200 experience. I'd need to defeat, what, 500 of them? For help to regenerate. Okay, we're almost at the hour mark, so I will be cutting this broadcast off shortly, but like I said, I want to get past the fourth floor. Let's explore the palace a little bit more. Maybe we're at the end of the palace. If so, we could end this episode in grand fashion. And hey, if not, we are one step closer to beating this game and an hour more into the game with some significant progress made. Half an hour's worth of grinding resulted in a new level and better equipment and, well, I guess just better equipment. And the surprise addition of the timer ring, and surprise reveal that we're strong enough to enter the mines and stand a chance. Oh. Thought he was going to put up a fight. He did. He thought wrong. Sorry, yellow dude. I'm gonna feel my wrath at this moment. Save it for all these green Paris. Still gonna save. Oh yeah, beautiful. One hit. Oh man. That'd be perfect if I wasn't gonna start grinding into the mines. Ah, you know, maybe there's some enemies on the fifth floor that give me some real great experience. Depending on what is on the fifth floor. Can I do anything with the Mask of Eyes here? Is there anything to see? Never used it. Nothing. These guys. See, 15-8, 2-6-8. 15-8, 15-8 to 59 to 268 to 28, a little over 100 apiece. Okay, fifth floor, more of these guys. Oh yeah, I think we were on the fifth floor briefly, so it's not new. Fifth floor, it's a little convoluted, however. Oh, we got a treasure chest. Aaron finds an ivory key. I can't think of anything that's been locked yet, so this must be used later on. So that right statue leads directly to the ivory key. Anything to do with the Mask of Eyes? I'm grasping at straws trying to find where this thing will work. This must be a very specific use. There must be a very specific use for this item. Okay, so we'll go to the left statue, and we may as well save. I mean, our health is still perfect. And I'm glad saying that didn't jinx us. There, we took some damage. Okay, so this is going to lead to the sixth floor. Again, we'll save. Let's finish exploring the fifth floor, see if there's anything else on here, on this floor for us. Ugh, options. That's what's left. Options. Yes. Okay, I'm guessing that's it for the fifth floor. Let's check out this statue before going to the stairs. Fifth floor is gonna fly by. We're not gonna do much here. Another treasure chest. A little bit of a tougher enemy, at least one that's putting up more of a fight. I know it's the same enemy I've dealt with, but definitely didn't seem like it. A silver shield, what? Man, right after we spent, what, 6,000 on that large shield? Let's see. What is my defense right now? Defense is 130. Equipping the silver shield puts my defense at 140. Wow, you know, in that one save I loaded up, they didn't have the silver shield. I think they had just three shields, three armors. Huh. Makes me curious about those saves. I figured those saves were at the end of the game. Oh. What was that? Huh. I figured those saves were at the end of the game, but maybe they weren't. Despite taking all that damage, we'll still save. So I wonder if there's a boss up here. Weaker enemies. This floor looks like it's going to be a little more confusing. It seems like these floors are getting... I take that back. Fifth floor. It seems like they're getting slightly more confusing, slightly more convoluted. Except for that fifth floor. That was pretty straightforward. I have no book. Oh yeah, I still... Again, if I am correct in assuming so, I still gotta find six books. I've found zero books so far. It looks like my health is past the halfway mark. My items look like I'm just about done finding items, but I've found no books. What's up with that? I'm trying to figure out how much of this game do I have left, stuff like that. It's kind of hard to figure out. But we have a couple statues. Those are going to transport me somewhere. Right now I'm just finding dead ends. Able to maintain this bit of health pretty long. 18,000 out of 25,000. Do I have 6,000 gold now? Sweet. Finds a marble key. I'm finding keys like crazy. Let's see. What did I want? My equipment. I wanted my status. 6,000 gold. I am raking it in now. Okay, and that was it for here, right? Man, I'm just about now at an hour 10. I'm making so much progress, I don't want to quit. So this may be an extra long episode. Chest is opened. Did I already get something out of there? Forget about it. Kind of losing my spot here. Okay, no, I'm not. This is where we started. Correction, this is where we started. Does that statue change whenever I use the mask of eyes? No. feel like I'm just going the same way I was originally going. Did I go in that room with that blue guy? I must have, because it looks like that was the only way to get over there. Thing to do with that here. Okay, I can still attack enemies while using this. Just can't see them. I don't know. Maybe I need to go down a floor. It looks like that treasure chest, that statue. I don't know that I've been to that statue, even though the treasure chest in the room has been opened, from what it appears to be. I need to hurry up and get back down before losing all my health. Probably gonna call it quits here. Have to start back up tomorrow or Saturday. Hopefully tomorrow, if I go in a day without playing this, I'm going to forget. I have to rewatch this video. It's a refresher. This blue statue, I gotta do something here. The lone blue statue, I mean, come on. Come on. I don't do anything with this here. Pushing buttons, nothing happening. And then that enemy trying to get me. I'm distracted. Okay, well. Tally-ho. Away we go. We'll save it there. 20,000 experience out of 25,000 experience. I'm gonna level up sooner than I thought. These enemies are really giving me lots of experience. And at 9,000 gold, I'm also getting lots of gold. And we've got some great stuff equipped too. We got that silver shield. Wow. Right after buying the large shield, and then we got Reflex. Found an additional ring, the timer ring. Bought the wing. We now know what the wing does. We now know that that is a consumable item. I'm gonna make sure to save over both these files just to make sure. And we'll see, what are we on? Like the sixth floor, the seventh floor? I don't remember anymore. But, hour 15 in, that's gonna do it. I think this turns out to be the longest video yet. What is this? And again, this was episode 6, right? I believe this was episode 6. Yes, it was. So, this will do for episode 6 of my Let's Play for Ease, The Vanished Omens on the Sega Master System. It's August 11th, 2016, Thursday evening. I do appreciate you watching this one. Stick around for the next one. Looks like we're getting ever closer to beating the game. Like, comment, subscribe, do all that good stuff. all that stuff that people proclaim at the end of YouTube videos, maybe even before YouTube videos or at the introduction of YouTube videos. While you're doing that, go ahead and check me out at mybrainongames.com. You can also check me out on Twitter as John Engelman, J-O-H-N-E-N-G-E-L-M-A-N. So, once more, thanks for watching. Do come back. Bye-bye.